If I could describe my mom, I'd say she's pretty resilient. I'm really proud of how far she's overcome in her life, and you know, she's an amazing person.
Milkiganarebit. She's a very strong woman.
When you have a Veronica on your side, anything is possible. Like, anything is possible.
I'm Veronica, and I'm a blood donor, and I'm also a stem cell donor. I'm from Butlitic First Nation. I'm Mi'kmaq, and I have 4 children, 2 grandchildren, and my husband. And we all live and work and play here. I'm a clinical therapist for my community. I've been in this industry, I would say, well over 20 years in the field of helping. Well, I first connected with Canadian Blood Services after seeing a poster on display at my place of work. There was a child on there that needed blood to live. I felt like, how could somebody read that and do nothing with it? That's honestly how I felt. When I was looking into donating blood on the website, I had seen the stuff with the stem cell registry and requested a kit. I did the swab and whatnot, and then I shipped it back off. I didn't give it much thought. I just said, let's just see what happens. So I was on the stem cell registry for 8 years before I got a call that I was a potential match for someone.
The first time I heard that she was going to give stem cells was exciting. It's a gift most people never get a chance to give. So for me, it felt really wonderful.
I think once she first found out that she could do it, she was excited, you know what I mean? She was excited that she had the opportunity to help somebody, you know?
When I told my dad that I was going to be donating my stem cells, he was a bit nervous for me. I had told him that, let's say if you've seen someone drowning and they had their arm outstretched to you, would you let them drown? For me, it was just a no-brainer. So the stem cell donation experience for me, it was a lot less than I had thought it would be in terms of how it was done. And even with my recovery, I went back to work the following day after I came back from Halifax. So there was really no downtime or evidence of me ever really getting it done.
She knew going into it, like, there might be a possibility, like, she might never, ever know the person that she donated, right? And when she found out, like, she was willing to share information with her, and she was very, you know, ecstatic.
Me and Jody finally met after almost 8 years of us corresponding back and forth. We have a lot of similarities by coincidence, even though we have 30 years between us.
Her meeting her in the end was really, it was beautiful seeing that. And I think she thinks the world of Judy.
Learning that Indigenous people only make up a small percentage of the registry, our hope, and I say our hope because Judy feels the same way I do, is that by doing something like this, maybe it would prompt people to go online and register and be a part of this.
Just to hear that a person who was on the verge of passing comes back to a good life, an extended life, because of the work Veronica does. That is a gift of life. I think more people should do this. More people. I don't know why they wouldn't do it, but I think everybody should do it. Right? That's what I think.